Honorable Mr. Justice Deepak Mishra, Chief Justice of India, Justice Lokur, Judge Supreme Court of India, Dr. Sanjay Baru, Secretary General FICCI, Mr. Arun Chawla, Deputy Secretary General FICCI, Advisor ICA, Honorable Judges, our guest speakers from different parts of the world. May I also request our guest speakers who have come all parts of the world to just stand. We want to give them an ovation. Please, please, please do that, sir. Members of the Indian Council of Arbitration, members of the legal fraternity, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed a great honor and pleasure for me to welcome you to this international conference. Sir, we are fortunate that today we have with us the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Honorable Mr. Justice Deepak Mishra. Our deepest gratitude to Justice Lokur, Justice Nageshwar Rao, Justice Arjun Sikri, Justice Sanjay Kishan Kaul, all judges of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, Justice T.S. Thakur, former Chief Justice, Supreme Court of India, Justice Nijjar, former Judge, Supreme Court of India, Justice Kohli, Judge, Delhi High Court, Justice Bhatt, Judge, Delhi High Court, Mr. Chandra, Law Secretary, Government of India, who have all agreed to come here today and participate in this conference. What a great honor for ICA. Sir, on the Constitution Day, our Chief Justice made two statements which really emboldened us, and that was one religion that every citizen would follow is the constitutional religion. Thank you very much, sir, for this statement. And the other thing which he said was the fundamental right of the citizen have to be kept at pinnacle. So we were really grateful to observe this. And with your these statements, sir, we have been emboldened, and particularly the judicial and the legal fraternity. Sir, ICA is today celebrating its 52 years. We were established by the Government of India, by the trade bodies like FICCI and ASSOCHAM, and it has been recognized one of the premier arbitral institutions in India. Sir, we have over 2,500 expert arbitrators on our panel. Sir, we have over 5,000 members. Sir, in 2015, we organized to commemorate our Golden Jubilee. We also organized an international conference which was attended by and which was by the Honorable Chief Justice of India, 5 Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court of India, 12 international speakers participated. Sir, last year, the Ministry of Finance asked us to organize a BRIC conference. I mean, this is how we have been perceived by not only by the commercial world, but even the Government of India has recognized the role of ICA. And when India was hosting the BRIC conference, ICA was asked to organize a BRIC conference of arbitration, which was also addressed by the Honorable Finance Minister, which was addressed by the Honorable Law Minister. And lawyers from different BRIC countries also participated in that conference, sir. Sir, we have been doing this for the last few years, these symposiums, seminars, international conference, interacting with government bodies, interacting with commercial world, interacting with also with the judges and judiciary to popularize arbitration and more so institutional arbitration, sir. Sir, what did we learn from these conferences and from these seminars and in last 2 years? The view, we have our speakers from different parts of the world. We collated their views. We collated the views of the commercial world. We all collated the views of Attorney General of India, who also participated. And in a nutshell, sir, the views which were expressed and the issues which were expressed, which to be taken note of, were inter alia, sir, I'll be very short and brief on that. The most important issue was that we must promote institutional arbitration. The other unanimous view was some or other we must not, or we can use that word, that we must shun ad hoc arbitration. This was the general consensus, sir.
Yes, sir.
There was also a consensus that we need to relook on the provisions relating to the setting aside of the award. It needs a relook. Mr. Bashin is here, but this view was also there that we must permit foreign lawyers to participate in the arbitration proceedings if we want to make India as a hub of international arbitration. The Attorney General was very firm that we must start having an arbitration bar, which is lacking. The other view was that the award should not be treated as a judgment of first court. In the BRIC conference, there was a general consensus that we must have an inbuilt provision of arbitration clause in all the bilateral investment treaties and commercial contracts. This was the general view, sir, when we had the BRIC conference. The other view was that judiciary should be sensitized to promote arbitration. This was also a view which was... The other view was, which we all have to ponder, was whether we should give the right to the parties to appoint arbitrators in a three-tier arbitration. It is the institution who should, because what happens in a three-tier arbitration, if two parties appoint an arbitrator and the third arbitrator, normally the arbitrator side with the parties who have appointed. So in a three-tier arbitration, whether the parties should have a right to nominate arbitrator. The interference, the other was the interference of judiciary in challenge of the award in the rarest of rare cases, sir. Like our death sentence, sir, in the rarest of rare cases. The third party funding, and the other view was imposing exemplary cost on the person challenging the award unsuccessfully. And there is a strong feeling, sir, very, very strong feeling, on the question of delay. Is it not a time that we impose a limit on a person taking arbitration cases or being an arbitrator? If we have a limit on the number of persons who can be a director on the board of companies, why can't we have a limit on the number of cases which an arbitrator can take in a particular year? That will really push arbitrator and it will avoid delays. This was a very strong feeling of the commercial world. Sir, we have over 1,200 arbitral institutions throughout the world, 1,200. The China, we have a lady from China, they only had the arbitration law, international arbitration law in 1994. And they have 240 arbitral institutions, 240. And we still have 30. Ad hoc arbitration, sir, is unknown in China. And in almost all the developed countries and developed worlds, the resolution of disputes are either through the mechanism of mediation or through institutional arbitration. So recently, Justice Sri Krishna gave a report on how to promote and popularize institutional arbitration. And in short, he said that there is a lack of government support, statutory and judicial backing to institutional arbitration. This was the summary of his report, sir. And he further went on to say that the arbitration to succeed has to succeed in countries which have friendly judiciary and statutory and government support. Sir, we have jumped in ease of doing business. As far as India is concerned, we have jumped 30 points. But as far as the enforcement of contract is concerned, sir, we still are in a very low position. Our ranking is 164. And the cost for enforcement of contract in India today is 31% as against 10 to 15% in developed and developing countries. This is one area which has to be looked into because the cost of enforcement of contract is very, very high, sir. Sir, in fact, I was very surprised when I came to learn that there has been no challenge. I stand corrected, but this is what I was told by Justice Sri Krishna, that there has been no challenge to an award ever in Netherlands. And only one award has been challenged in Switzerland successfully. This was a statement made by Justice Sri Krishna when we were having a seminar in Mumbai. So I made a note of it. I don't know whether it's right or wrong, but he made that statement. We have people from Switzerland. I don't know whether it's right or wrong, but this is the statement Justice Sri Krishna made. Sir, if you look at India today, why we have so many speakers from international world? Because they look at India very differently today. It's a new India. It's a new India. And they said that by 2030, the China will have an economy of $38 trillion. USA will have an economy of, this is the report of the World Economic Forum. The USA will have an economy of $23 trillion. And in India will have an economy of over $19 trillion. And sir, as far as the Japan is concerned, it will only have an economy of over $5 trillion. This is what India will be, and India is going to be in the next 10 to 15 years. They said the two largest economies of the world will be in the BRIC countries, that is India and China. They further go on to say that the future of the world market will be in China, and India, and Africa. The report further goes on to say that the USA, China, and India are the most promising FDI destination. Sir, there was a very recent survey, and this survey is known as Access to Justice Survey. And it made a very startling revelation that over 70% of the Indians wants to resolve their disputes through the medium of mediation, conciliation, and arbitration. They don't want to go to the court of law. And this was the latest survey which came a week back only. Sir, the buzzword is that we need to change the way we arbitrate. Our mindset has to change. And lastly, to give support to the growing economy like India, it is very imperative that the commercial disputes, both national and international, are resolved in a most speedy and a cost-effective manner. And one of the most prudent way to do it is to promote institutional arbitration and to have a robust arbitration law in tune with international norms. Sir, we have well-developed commercial law. Our judgments are cited in various parts of the world. This is my own experience. And we have indisputably the great legal brains. I see no reason why we can't succeed and why cannot we make India as a hub of international arbitration. And sir, I can assure you that with little support from the government and the judiciary, we will succeed and we will make arbitration succeed in India. Thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot.